In this video, I'm going to give you an overview of the Teams desktop application, as well as looking at some key settings. This is Teams 2.0, or new Teams. We've explained the difference between this and the old Teams in a blog, which I'll link in the video description if you want to know more. We'll start over here on the left, where you have various tabs and applications. The first six tabs, Activity, Chat, Teams, Calendar, Calls, and OneDrive, are standard. In the other videos in this playlist, we'll look at each tab in more detail. Now, if there's a tab you don't use, you can unpin it in favour of other applications. Just right-click and click Unpin. You can also reorder these tabs by simply dragging and dropping. You then have this View More Apps button. This allows you to see more apps that you have installed within Teams. If you want to add one to your sidebar for quick access, you simply right-click and select Pin. You can now see the app on my sidebar. When you click on a tab, it will open in the main Teams window, but you can right-click and press Open in a new window. This is useful if you want to have the app open and work on something else within Teams. Also in View More Apps, you have a search bar to search for apps, or you can click on the Get More Apps button, which will take you to the Teams App Store. Another way to access the Teams App Store is in your sidebar. In the App Store, you'll see a range of apps that you can add to your Teams. This includes those built for your organization, such as Power Apps, and you can see popular apps, industry-specific apps, and more. You are also able to set up custom workflows here to automate tasks. Next, we're going to look along the top of our Teams app. First, we have these arrows. These allow you to go back and forward between your previously visited apps. You can also hover over the arrow to see and pick from your recent places. You then have the search bar. This can be used to search for people, messages, files, and more. If we move over to the right, these three dots are your settings and more. We'll come back to these shortly. You then have a notification icon. However, this is for notifications from your other Teams accounts. If I click here on my account name and icon, you'll see that I have two Teams accounts. So the notification icon will tell me if there's activity in my other account, which is handy to stay on top of things if you do have multiple accounts. Back under my account name and icon, you can see that I can easily switch between those accounts by just clicking. I also have the option to set my status, work location, and a status message on the current account. Here there is also the option to sign out of this Teams account. Now back to settings and more. Under this dropdown we have settings. We then have cast, which allows you to cast your Teams to a nearby Teams room. Help allows you to access training, see what's new, suggest features, and give feedback. You also have the option to zoom further into your Teams window if needed, see keyboard shortcuts for the apps. There's quite an extensive list of shortcuts that you can use. Download the mobile app, and this is also where the toggle is for old and new Teams, though we suggest sticking with new. I'm going to open settings just to show you a few key ones. First, under General, Auto Start of Teams is handy to switch on as it automatically opens the app when you switch on your device. There are also options about the display of windows and chats, so if you'd like them to open in the main Teams window or a new window. And further down, you can toggle support features like suggested replies and spell check. Under Privacy, some good features include the ability to allow notifications from certain people when you're on Do Not Disturb, and you can also switch off red receipts here for chats. Under Notifications and Activity, you can just play around with how you want to receive different notifications. In Appearance and Accessibility, there are different themes. At the moment, I'm on the Classic theme, but there is also a Light theme, a Dark theme, and a High Contrast theme. There are also some other visual changes you can make, such as compacting chats to fit more messages on the screen. Under Files and Links, you can choose where your downloads go. This allows you to choose a different location than the standard downloads folder. Here you can also choose your preference for how files open, either in the Teams app, the respective desktop app, or in your browser. And lastly, device is another good settings section to look at, as you can select your camera and microphone and also do checks and adjustments to those. That's an overview of Teams and some key settings. This video is part of an introductory series to the Teams desktop application. In the next video, we look at the activity feed.